Absolute value, and absolute value can be quite complicated, but we have the easier version here. This is absolute value on the outside, so the absolute value of y. So we don't need to reverse anything, so this one isn't too complicated. So we can just focus on the outside first, and we can just say the change in y. And really, I'm going to take all the old y's. Looks like I'm going to do the absolute value first, make it opposite sign, and then add 1. So I take the absolute value of negative 2, make it negative, so it's negative 2, positive 2, then becomes negative 2, plus 1 becomes negative 1, negative becomes positive, positive becomes negative because of the outside, plus 1 gives me 0, 0 is 0, 1 becomes negative 1 plus 1, and it gives me 0. And the transformation that is going to happen is I'm going to take the square root graph, I'm going to reflect it across the x-axis, and then I'm going to flip it and shift it up 1. Okay, so if I take this graph here, this is really the square root graph that looks something like this. I'm going to bend it up like that. I'm going to flip it upside down, so it's going to now look like that. Okay. And then I'm going to shift it up 1, so it's going to look something like that. Okay, so I'm going to be a little bit more precise when I actually draw in the coordinates. The x's are fairly straightforward. The change in x is just going to be 2 to the left. So my change in x is going to be, well, my x new plus 2 equals x old. So I'm just going to go 2 to the left. Okay, again, this is my notation. This is what actually happens. So I'm going to do this to get to there. So minus 2, minus 2, minus 2, minus 2. The thing that I have to be careful of is this point here is my reflection point. Okay, this is a point of where I'm reflecting. I'm going to bend it because this is, I do the absolute value first, so the 0 is the point that doesn't change. So everything underneath gets folded up. So I just have to be a little bit careful in that. I'm going to get a kink in that point. So I'm going to draw that one first. So 2, 1, negative 2, x is negative 2, y is negative 1. So I'm going to end up here, negative 1, 0. So it's going to look like that, and then 7, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, sorry, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 and 0 is going to be like that. So it's going to kind of go off like that. Okay, so there's my graph. This one's a little bit hard to draw because this point here, we have to recognize if we just drew the coordinates in, it's we'd be looking at something that looks like this. I'm just going to erase this. We'd be looking at something like that, and it's kind of hard to tell what's going on there. But if you recognize that this fold point is a point where it's going to kind of fold, we know it curves like this, and then the curve changes like that as we go through that point. Okay, so there's my graph. So if I had to describe the changes, I'm just going to go off the description here. So my change in y is going to be, first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to fold it or reflect across x-axis. That's the first step. Okay, the second step is I'm going to flip it. So I'm going to do a vertical flip. And the last thing that happened here is a vertical shift plus 1. The changes in x are fairly straightforward. The change in x, there's only one thing that happens. It's a horizontal shift to the left 2.